the Lord. You are welcome to today's session of worship and sharing from the Word of God, another first day of the week when we celebrate the victory of the new covenant over the powers of death and over the powers of the old creation. We are grateful that God has brought you to be part of today's sharing in the Word of God and the service for today. We shall be discussing the topic for today, taken from Luke chapter 9, verse 23. Luke 9, 23. If any man will come after me, let him deny himself. If any man will come after me, let him deny himself. This is the Chapel of Grace, the University of Maiduguri, here in Nigeria. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this hour. We pray, O God, that you will touch every one of us, every one of your children, in every part of this world, every part of this nation. Father, wherever they log in to be part of this ministration, Lord, we ask that your grace will touch every life. Lord, there will be impartation, there will be exhortation, there will be inspiration, and there will be transformation in the lives of every one of us that will partake in this ministration. Let all the glory be yours. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We are discussing, as continuation of the part of our program for the whole year, we are focusing on Christ in you, the hope of glory, taken from Colossians chapter 1, verse 27. And for this month, we are focusing on I have been crucified with Christ. You see, everything is just centered on Christ, because that's what the Christian faith is all about. A faith that has nothing else but focus on Christ. That's why it's called Christianity. And Christianity is not merely about, you know, being self-pleased, you know, being appreciative to God, or having assurance concerning what God has done for us in Christ. That is usually the beginning. But it is actually about a daily God-pleasing adoration, a daily God satisfaction, God service, God submission, you know, Christ surrender. We do everything. That is what is the worship of the Christian faith. It's not just the thing we get, the expectation we get, but the expectation that's expected of us by God himself. It's not how we are just pleased in Christ, but how God is pleased in us because of what Christ has done for us. That's the worship part of Christianity. And we will be focusing a little bit on that as we go along. If any man will come after me, let him deny himself. You see, the Christian faith is for everybody, is for any man, for any woman, any boy, any girl. It's for every and for whosoever. Everyone, whosoever. And so that's why it is put in a conditional way. Now, it is if you are willing. God is already willing, and God has given. God has opened the door. God has given the access. It is if you, whosoever will, It is if you, that's when you obtain, because God already will and God has already given. But except you take it, it will remain there. And when you don't take it, it's actually accounting against you. And that's the thing. So it is if any man, doesn't mean that, well, if you like, no, you better like it. You had better. It is either you take it or you miss it. So everyone should desire to come after Jesus. And everyone should deny himself. Now, you notice that he said, come after. He didn't say, come unto. And don't ever try to confuse the two. They are clearly the words after and unto, they don't even look alike. So it's not a mistake that, well, you know, you might try to say come after, you say come unto. No. It is a deliberate distinction between come unto and come after. Come unto precedes come after. And the fact that you have come unto will not stop Jesus from still saying, if any man who has come unto me will come after me. God is sovereign, but you have your own responsibility according to the sovereignty of God. It is God that in his sovereignty has decided that he will sovereignly give you, but you will responsibly take it. That's the way God has taken it. God will never force you. Jesus will not crash your door. He will knock on the door. He will sovereignly come and start knocking without you even knowing about it. But you will have to do the opening of the door. That is how God has decided that. And so when we talk about coming, we need to know that coming encounters are not the same. There is a coming encounter of unto Jesus. There is a coming encounter of after Jesus. And you have to be, as you are reading the scripture, pay attention so that you get the matter in its context. The same way, you know, it's also about, if you read down in the chapter, in the verse we are talking, Luke chapter 9, verse 23, he says, and Jesus said to them all, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. So, you see, even cross, once you hear cross, it doesn't always mean the same thing. There is a cross of being crucified on the cross. There is also the cross of taking the cross daily to follow. There is a cross you die. There is a cross you take daily. And it's important we get these things and not have a lopsided mindedness because we model up what is two, we put it into one. A coin that has two sides and you delete one side and put it on the other side remains a false coin. It remains a counterfeit. You keep both sides and then you have a true coin. A money bill that has two sides, you delete one side and superimpose it on the other side, is a fake bill. The bill must have both sides. And it's important we never model up things, nor get confused about it, nor use one to replace the other. No. God will help us even as we go on this. So I'm going to take these two aspects, not just taking it one after the other, but also taking them pari passu, coming unto and coming after. Jesus said the same thing in various other places. Like in Matthew 11, 28, he says, "Come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." There is a coming. You come because you are laboring, and you come, you'll be given rest from that labor. And that is called coming unto. But there is a coming after you come. You carry cross and labor daily to follow him. That is important. And we'll see that in Matthew 16, 24 again. Then Jesus said unto his disciples, you see, the address about coming unto so that you rest from your labor is usually to the multitude. But the message about coming after, so that you take up the cross and labor following him, is usually the message for the disciple. So the multitude of the people, there's an evangelistic message of invitation. Come unto. But to the members of the church, the disciples, there is a stewardship message. There is a discipleship message that challenges them to take up the cross and get busy. The other one is, stop being busy, come and rest. And then when you've come, you rest from your vain labors, and then you'll be taught how to not rest now, but to take up the cross and labor with the yoke of Jesus. Because the yoke of your dead works is useless and destructive. But the yoke of Jesus' labor is light and gives life. So that is why he uses come unto me, and thereafter come after me. Praise the Lord. So one is about invitation, conversion, about conviction, about salvation. Come unto me. And the other one is about commissioning, about conduct, about commitment, about stewardship. Come after me. And if you look further and we just take it one after the other, let's summarize these two. One is a call to faith for grace. Call to faith for grace. You come and God will give you his grace, because that coming is about coming unto, is about putting your trust in him for salvation. He will give you the grace that will quicken you from death, the grace that will deliver you from sin, the grace that will give you dominion over flesh, Satan, and self, and sin, the grace that gives you power for victory. But when you have received that grace, it becomes vain if you do nothing with it. And many a time we stop at this evangelistic level. And even when we are preaching and teaching the congregation, we keep giving the same salvation message, as we call it. The same evangelistic message. The same assurance of salvation. We never talk about commitment or stewardship. And all the questions people are asking, well, now that I have come unto him, I hope I must have assurance of going to heaven. God did not call you to himself to go to heaven. He called you to himself to work for the kingdom. He called you to himself to make heaven to come down, for heaven, as it's done in heaven, to be done on earth. It's not for you to go to, but to bring heaven down. That's why God has called you. And people will just say they are not doing anything. They are not doing it on earth as done in heaven. They are just saying, I hope I must go to heaven. I have to go to heaven, eh? I must go to heaven, oh. And he thinks that's for, no. Jesus said, every day when you pray daily, asking for your daily bread, you also daily hallow the name of the Lord, and daily pray and work that it will be done on earth as it's done in heaven. You are saved to bring heaven down. If you don't bring heaven down, then you will not go to heaven. You don't go to heaven when heaven is not down through your life. It's when your life is a heaven channel, that's when you become a heaven candidate. But when your life is not a heaven channel, then forget it. There's no channel for you to go to heaven. And it's very important. But in modern cultural Christianity, the modern popular pagan mentality we use to do our Christian faith today, we often try to just focus on what we want. We never remember what God wants. You are called not because of what you want. You are called because of what God wants. And so don't stop at celebrating that you are saved and say, praise God, I'm saved. Thank God for the grace. There is a race to be run. There is a victory to be won. There is an end to overcome unto. There is a goal to press to. And so you don't sit down glorying in the past or even in the present. You must strive and press and run and push to the end. And that's where coming after that we are talking today comes in. Coming after. We are called to come after, to follow Christ, to walk in him. You know, when you are coming unto, he's waiting for you to come unto him. You are coming to a waiting Christ. But when you are coming after, you are coming to a walking Christ, a moving Christ. And we need not just to come, that is waiting for us. When we now come and he starts walking, we say, well, have I not come? I've come. Oh. I've come. They tell you where he's moving. You say, well, since I've come, he has to just take me along. Go. I have come. Look, there is a coming unto, and there is a coming after. So if you have come unto, that is when you must begin to come after. And the Lord will see you through. In fact, grace is given to you so that you can come after. If you don't use grace to come after, then you will not run the race for which grace is given to you. And when you don't run the race, there's no glory for you. If you don't press forward, you will not get to the goal. You will draw back unto perdition. But the desire of God is that we will press forward unto the saving of souls. And we pray that God will help us today. Lord, teach us. Teach us the basic things that we will not walk in error or in ignorance. The Lord will help us not to do that. We will not have time to go through the whole of that chapter, but it was when Jesus was asking the disciples, he asked them, who do people say I am? There was no multitude there. There was nobody to evangelize. These are people already evangelized. They were disciples. They have already come unto him. And he asked them, the people that are yet to come unto him, who do they say I am? And they say, well, they say this, they say that, they say, okay, you that have already come unto me, who do you say I am? And they say, you are the Christ. They say, good. Now, don't tell this to those who are yet to come unto me. But for you that have come unto me, I want to tell you the next thing. You need to come after me. And this is very important. So you, Christian, you have come unto the Lord. Are you coming after him? Are you ready to deny yourself? Die to yourself and deny yourself daily and carry your cross daily and follow him daily. Are you ready for that? Some people tell you, well, I gave my life to Christ. Yes, you gave your life to Christ. But are you giving yourself, your service, your stewardship? Are you doing it for Christ daily? Yes, you came unto him. in the year 2040. But today, are you coming after him, following him? You came and put faith in him, but are you coming to follow him? It's important that the Lord will open our eyes to grasp these things and to walk in them. Because if we don't walk in them, our Christianity will be a lopsided Christianity. And when your Christianity is a Christianity that has faith, or that has faith and has grace, but it has no race, it has no works, then the grace is vain and the faith is dead. If you have grace and you have faith, you don't use the grace for the race, the grace is vain. You don't use the faith for works, the faith is dead. The Lord will help us, that we that have begun, the message today is, if you have begun, make sure you run. If you have started, make sure you end. If you have committed yourself to Christ, make sure you overcome unto the end. Don't hope to overcome unto before the end. Overcome unto the end. No matter the tribulation, antichrist, super antichrist, extra super antichrist, tribulation, greater, greatest tribulation, whatever comes, you have grace to take on the worst that Satan can bring. Don't say, well, if I ever find myself this, then I am finished. You cannot be finished, because grace is sufficient and you are complete in him. You can stand the worst that hell can bring. And you need to know that. Carry your cross, deny yourself, follow him, and come after him. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. Thank you, O God, because you have called us unto yourself, and you have called us after yourself. We pray, O God, that as Christians, we shall be Christians of unto the Lord, and Christians of after the Lord. That whatever comes, Lord, we shall not draw back. We shall deny ourselves. We shall carry the cross, not only to be crucified, but also to carry it. Father, that we will follow you, not only just to come and stand, but also to walk with you and to walk after you, in step with your spirit. Father, may nothing ever stop any of your children. May this day be a day of decision to press and to hit the end, to overcome unto the end. Thank you for hearing our prayers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace. The blessings of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you all, now and forevermore. Amen. God bless you.
Your name is holy. You are so holy to me. Somebody say,
I call you holy. Your name is holy. Holy you.